Our story begins some 2,000 years ago. In just a few moments, the crowd that had gathered would decide if Jesus would be set free or hung on a cross for his alleged crimes. So Pontius Pilate, overseeing the prosecution, arranged to speak with Jesus before the sentencing commenced. Many a criminal had stood accused before the powerful Roman leader, but this one was different. People had been claiming that he could heal the sick, give sight to the blind, and make the crippled walk again. What does the mighty Pontius ask this apparent Messiah in his last moments on earth? He asks, "What is truth?" In the same way, we as a nation are asking ourselves this question: what is truth? You see, some claim that truth is dead, that all we have left are lies, rumors, and fake news. Others claim that truth is to be molded by one's thoughts, feelings, and experiences. After all, who is God to say what is right and what is wrong? It's in this moment you realize how truly lost we are. You see, truth is not a block of clay made to be shaped in our image. Instead, it is a mirror designed to reflect back to us our imperfections, deepest flaws, and unmet potential. The reality is that we were never supposed to shape truth. Instead, truth is supposed to shape us. Let us look back at the end of our story. Pontius Pilate stared into the eyes of God in the flesh, listened to his words as he claimed to be truth, and walked out to the crowds of people longing to see Jesus dead and said, "I find no guilt in him." But just moments later, stood before that crowd, washed his hands and said, "I am innocent of this man's blood. It is your responsibility." You see, Pontius Pilate knew the truth, but his own belief wasn't enough. When met with a world that said they had no need for truth, that it was time for truth to die. So the question is, what will you do with truth? Will you wash your hands of it, continuing to believe that we no longer need it? Will you accept the lie that it is whatever the world wants it to be? Or will you use truth as a mirror to change yourself and change the world? It's time for people to understand that just like it was for Pontius Pilate, the moments where it is hardest to stand for truth will be the moments that most shape history.